In this video, we are going to see exactly how to create tables precisely and avoid common mistakes. Why do you want to use tables? Well, that's a different question. Have a look at this video, which explains 18 benefits of using tables. The simplest way of creating a table is just click inside the data, insert table. By default, it puts some formatting, puts auto filter, and you will see a small corner icon, which is basically a drag handle. In this table, data is exactly same, but I have already put some formatting. I am going to do exactly the same steps. It will create a table, but the formatting which is shown here is not getting applied. Why is it not getting applied? Because you already had some manually applied formatting, so table doesn't overwrite it. You have to tell the table to overwrite it. How do you do that? Right-click on any formatting you want to apply and choose Apply and Clear Formatting. There's one more common problem. Sometimes the formatting which is applied is not just for making the data look good. This yellow and red has a meaning. And now if I use the same method I showed you just now, insert table. In fact, you never are going to go there. Ctrl-T is the shortcut. If I remove the formatting from here, this is a bad idea. This is wrong. Don't do it. Why? Because this formatting has a meaning. Whatever that meaning is, hopefully you know. So add that meaning in a separate column first and then make the table. And now that the meaning is captured correctly, you can get rid of the unwanted formatting. So table design, right-click, apply and clear formatting. So far, I did not select the range because I could see the entire data on one screen. Now this data, the endpoint, I cannot see. So if I choose Ctrl-T, it will try to select something. If there are empty rows, it's going to stop there. But more importantly, notice what happened here. These are actually subtotals. And by mistake, I included them. So all my calculations and analysis is going to be wrong. So it's important to see the boundary of the data. Look at the last row, look at the last column at least, and make sure you're selecting only the data portion. Table should contain the raw data. Yes, it can contain calculated columns, but not summarized columns like subtotals or grand total. So what are the rules required for a table? Simple. Each column should have a heading. There cannot be duplicate headings. There cannot be empty headings. If I delete this, it's going to put it as column 1. If I put this forcibly as amount, see what happens? In order to make them unique, it renames them. No formulas in the heading and no merge cells. If there are merge cells and you try to create a table, it's going to unmerge cells and those empty things will become column 1, column 2. And to make matters worse, this is a double layered heading. So ideally this data clean version should be like this. But data cleaning is a separate topic altogether. Have a look at this video. How do I know I am inside a table? Many people think that they'll see the auto filter or this icon or this typical formatting. Those are not very reliable. The correct way to find out whether you are currently inside a table is to look for the table design menu. If I click outside, the menu goes away. If I click inside a table, the menu comes in. This is the most reliable method. Now, while we are at the table design, it's a good idea to go to the first option and give it a better name. Press enter. Name must start with some kind of text and it cannot contain spaces. As you start using tables, you're going to need to know the names of tables very frequently. To see the name, every time I have to click inside the table, go to table design, and only then I can see the name. That's a bad idea. It's a very frequently referred point. So right-click on the table name, add to quick access toolbar. And now it'll be visible here. In fact, ideally you should have this quick access toolbar below the ribbon so that you get more space. Bottom line, as soon as you add a table, give it a better name. Sometimes the data does not get selected fully, like this, because there was an empty row. I already created a table, no problem. Go to this corner drag handle and incorporate the new data. If you want to do something on a larger scale, of course you can go to table design, resize table, and provide a range as well. When you're creating a table, look at the dialog. Of course, it is showing you the range, but there is also a checkbox about headers. Excel tries to check, does your data have headers? If it thinks your data has headers, then it will enable this checkbox automatically. So you just have to consciously notice what is it saying and does it match with actual status of headers. For example, in this case, it correctly understands that my table does not have a header. Now what do? I leave it alone because it will automatically put the headers. But in this case, I actually know that month and status are the headers, but Excel did not detect because there was no differentiation, all were text. So in this case, I have to tell Excel, yes, it does have a header. If you don't pay attention, look at what will happen. Month and status will also become data and it will forcibly put column 1, column 2. We don't want that. How do you select a table itself? Click anywhere inside, press Ctrl A. It doesn't matter whether there are empty rows or empty cells because table defies the boundary anyway. Ctrl A selected only the data, not the header. One more Ctrl A will select the header. But if my cursor happened to be inside a header, then in one Ctrl A, I'll select the whole thing. Of course, the next level Ctrl A will select the whole sheet. How do you select a column? If I wanted to do some formatting, I would select a column like this. Don't do that. That puts a lot of unwanted formatting, increases file size. So look at the cursor. There's a column kind of cursor. Come down. See this. This is table column level cursor. So one click, it'll select everything. Even if there were blank cells, it doesn't bother. And this is the right way to select columns in tables. In the same way, you can select rows as well. You take the cursor just somewhere here, the row selection part comes into picture. Again, when you are selecting a row, doesn't matter whether there are blank cells or not, it will always select the correct row. Now, how do you add more rows? Well, you just type somewhere outside the table, it will incorporate. If you leave a gap and type, it will not. If you copy paste something and it is touching the table, it will still work. Often, we want to add a column before the first column of the table. Don't add a column like this because if you do that, it's going to be outside the table. So go to the first column, right-click and say insert table columns to the left. Sometimes we want to remove the table and just keep it as a range. A rare requirement, but yes, you should know. So go to the table design menu and choose convert to range. The moment I say convert to range, it's saying, do you want to convert? Yes. And now it looks like a table. The formatting is retained, but it's no longer a table. Another important thing, often we use conditional formatting and the base formatting of the table interferes with that. So this blue and this blue are not really gelling together. It's visual confusion. So what do? So go to table design, open this drop down. Don't look for something which will look good. There is a formatting called no formatting, none. Whenever you are going to do anything visual on top of the data, use this kind of formatting so you get all the benefits of table without the visual confusion. While we are at it, explore the table menu itself. Of course, you can create a pivot table from here directly, remove duplicates without having to select the whole table, and you can use insert slices. Slices are amazing visual interactive filters. I have a separate video for that as well. There are at least two places where tables get created automatically. When you have a pivot table and you double click on any cell in the value area or totals, it creates a new sheet and gives me the underlying data. This data automatically becomes a table. Another place where tables are created automatically is when you are getting data from Power Query. When you import data from Power Query as a table, of course, it's going to become a table. So that is how you create and manage tables correctly. I strongly recommend you see the benefits of table video as well. It'll definitely make your Excel work more efficient, less error prone, and faster. So that's it for now. Thank you.